people, what up? Good afternoon. It's your girl Christiana D again. I'm so excited. Let me introduce you first now. I'm so excited because I'm filming YouTube video for the first time in a very long time. Like, I don't know what happened. Anyways, but then we are here, and as you can see, I'm not alone. I have somebody right beside me.
A
She's a superstar, celebrity, one and a F. Let me tell you something. The church that I am, she does not attend my church. But almost everybody in my church, they know her more than they know me. Some people don't know me, but they know her. She's in another church. That's how popular she is. She's made of stuff. When you say a lady is made of stuff. Anyways, no other person but Anna F.
Yo, yo.
The CEO and orchestrator, creator of Random Talks with Anna F. I know that you know that too. Anyway, so I brought her today and I'm so happy because I know that I've been telling you for a very long time. I'm going to bring you to my video, and then we have Apostolos. She's my guest on Apostolos today too. Anyway, so we have something interesting to talk about, and trust me, I know that I've not made a mistake by bringing her. She seems to be in the perfect position to actually discuss this because she's a people's person.
Lord,
so she has,
don't let me fall down.
So she has a lot of experiences from people. Like, she has a lot of people at her disposal, even though they don't have to be her close friends, but she has a lot of people, trust me. So she can be a brand influencer if you want to use her. Anyways, so what we want to talk about today is envy and jealousy. Yeah, so we're going to be defining what the difference between envy and jealousy is, then we go into what causes envy. I don't want us really focus on jealousy because that seems to be like, it's not as bad as envy. Envy is really what I want us to talk about. But the reason I'm saying jealousy is because people mix it up. So I just want us to quickly state the difference. But I want us to focus more on envy. So what makes people envious? What brings about envy? And then how can we, you know, what are the consequences and how to actually avoid envy? So let's start. The difference between envy and jealousy.
My Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord, we thank you for today. Father, don't let me fall.
That's
how all
people do. Oh, yeah,
all right. So, okay. Let's define these terms. I think that would help us to know the difference. I think jealousy is wishing that what somebody has belongs to you. I think that's jealousy. And envy is unhealthy jealousy. You know, when you're jealous of somebody and you're wishing the person bad, like, okay, somebody got a phone and you are saying that, ah, I wish I have this kind of phone. Got a gym or lower. Witchcraft, that's envy. So all right, so that's the difference between jealousy and envy. And
sorry, you said jealousy is like when you wish to have something somebody has, but you don't wish the person bad.
Yes, you don't.
Is there not also this part, because I just remembered now, I'll talk about it, that how about the cases where somebody, you feel that what belongs to you is being threatened,
okay,
or a sort of somebody wanting to take away something that is yours.
Okay.
For example, our God is a jealous God. Mm-hmm. He doesn't want to share. He doesn't want us to share with
but
anybody.
Does that mean God is bad?
Of course not. Mm-hmm. But I'm also just stating that there is also that aspect of jealousy where that thing belongs to you, and somebody is wanting to
good
take it.
Good, that's another.
All right, angle. Proceed, that's proceed.
Nobody can take Christian away from me. I will not allow it. All right, so okay, I think you asked causes of envy, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the basic thing for me that I think causes envy is covetousness, right? When you're covetous, you're not contented with what you have. You always want to get everything. You always want to achieve everything. Forgetting that life is all about ups and downs. You cannot achieve everything. You know, so I feel that's like the basic thing about this envy thing. It's the basic. Okay. Let me cast her. She has... You bitch not come and rob her. But she has a lot of shoes. Right, then if you look at, if you go to her closet, she has clothes.
Lol,
Capri Adoma were the same size. In now, I should now be there. I know that we are not wearing the same size, right? I know that our size is useless to me and for me. Now, I'm now there. I'm like, are you the only one? You know, Shane, somebody should just come, they should just come and rob her and collect all the shoes. What's it? She'll be the one to wear to match. You wear purple. she went blue. See her skirt. She's wearing green. Now only she got that is called okay. Now, if they steal those shoes from her and they bring it to me, please, what is it going to do for me? So that is covetousness. When what you have, it's not like I don't have shoes too now. I have shoes, shoe get size, okay, can get quality. I have my shoe size and I have my own thing, right? But I'm just there like, oh, I don't like the way she's doing drip on drip. This girl can do drip on drip, I'm telling you. Yeah, anywhere you see a pillar.
After billing her face, you did not see what she's wearing. See that gown last song. Should I show you the shoes? What to this
guys?
You have the wristwatch, so don't come and start.
All right, so yeah, I think that's the basic. Don't let us waste time. I think that's basic reason for envy. That's covetousness, right? And so many other reasons that I cannot think of now. It's just that I have people that are too. She has said I should break tables. Seriously, I have people that are too. They are just too covetous. They are too covetous. Now I have okay. Shout out to Sweet Spoon. I'm using called Dawo advertisement. Okay, all right. So there is this kitchen that I patronize a lot, Sweet Spoon Kitchen. I love pancakes. I don't know how to make. I've tried.
And I have egg. I have flour. I have sugar. I have milk.
All right, let's do it. Let's cut.
No. Let's finish. I beg.
All right. So okay. I love pancakes. I don't know how to do it. I've tried several times. Try and error. In fact, one son of man too has helped me. Right. We did not get it. So this Sweet Spoon, she has a way of doing it so beautiful. If I don't have savings, a Sweet Spoon. Now I have friends at the office and they'll be like, okay, Anna, you've ordered Sweet Spoon. I'm like, right, I have ordered Sweet Spoon. Okay. I want to order Sweet Spoon too, but I don't have money. Fam, what am I supposed to do? Can we just share? How far now? You've just eaten. You've just finished eating. Na. You still want to share my pancake, my Sweet Spoon pancake? What you talking about? What? Covetousness. Of a truth, she doesn't like that food. Of a truth, she doesn't. To her, the food was not nice. Of a truth. And then secondly, she had eaten that this day that I told you about, that I just said something about. She had eaten. She ate porridge that day, and she still came because I don't know. Maybe. They always want to do what I don't know.
Let's look at it from the competitive perspective. You mentioned now that you wanted to buy Mama Put, right? And then she was like, she wants to buy it too. So someone always wanting to do what you do, even when they don't see the need to do it. Please give us fuel that.
You
came from what you said.
You're actually the host. You should fuel it by yourself.
I called you. You are the guest here. Now, do you want us to be showing film for them now?
That's true.
This is live international video.
Proceed.
Competitive part. Because I know we've had a discussion around competition and all. So say it. Talk.
Okay. So let me put it out there that I know that there are some what's it called now? There are some temperaments that are naturally competitive. They don't see anything bad in it. They just want to be at the top of their game. If they see you buy something, they want to buy more than what you've gotten. If they see you do this thing, if you hold a concert, they hold a seminar. If you hold a seminar, they will do conference. If you do conference, they will do something bigger than. It's not because they want to just show off. It's just their nature. I can't really remember. I don't want to put out wrong information out there, but I think it's choleric, the temperament.
Okay.
But then there are some people that is not temperament that is doing this one. It's not even zodiac sign. I be zodiac, because some people say I'm a Taurus. I'm a Leo. Blame it on my Leo.
By the way, we should not be defined by those signs.
You are not okay. I'm a Leo.
Blame it on my Leo.
Leopardi.
And those names are sweet.
Leopardi. So there are some people that it's not their temperament. It's not their whatever sign. It's just they are just like that bittered. They just want to compete with you. They are just
bitterness causes envy. More. We are learning. We are jotting. Proceed. We were still on competition. You went straight into bitterness. Please proceed. Don't let us forget.
All right. So some people they just want to compete with you because they don't want to see you grow. They don't want to see you do something. Now it's so worse that if you do something they are doing. Let's take for instance that they started selling, or they are into surprise, whatever, this surprise thing, I'm a surprise company. Yeah. And you decide that, all right, I feel I can prosper in this business. Let me go into it. My dear, they will do everything in their power to make sure that you don't succeed. Because they just don't want you to get to their level. And if it were to be that reverse was the case, they would also do things that will make you calm down, so they would go up. We have so many people like that. We have so many. That is why, if it is 9-to-5 job that works for you, I beg, do it. Because entrepreneur is not for everybody. You will see people that are under you, that they will just do something for you, blah blah blah, like that, and all of your business will just come crashing and crumbling. And after you crash, they will now go and start that same business. Because they just want to be better than you are. They just want to compete with you. Kilo de shit. Oh, fine, you fine.
Okay, so competition. A lot of people have that competitive spirit.
Right.
So it often leads to envy. Mm-hmm. So yeah, and I see that, okay, you started this relationship because you're a relationship coach. Mm-hmm. And you do when we gather.
Right.
So when I now noticed that, the first one, come and see how people came in this next level, youth asking questions. Christy, you to go and come and start doing all this. I'll just change my own name from when we gather to maybe when we come together, when we accommodate, when we assemble,
when we unite.
Competition. But I feel that there are healthy competitions too, right?
Correct.
You do something and I'm just challenged. No. You inspire me. So I see you doing something, and but I think the difference now is I'm not now doing it in your own field. I will not go to my field and do it.
And I'm not even doing it to bring you down.
Yes, I'm just doing it for my own self, because I feel like I should also be growing and developing.
Shout out to Kiki and Tomike. If you know them on Instagram, you see, I am a
follow them. She made me start following them.
I am a diehard fan of Tomike and Kiki on Instagram. And these two people, right? I look at them. I look at Kiki. I look at Tomike. Then bring out some things, some values inside of both of them, and then join it together to make my own brand and grow. Now, in that aspect, I'm not in competition with them, or maybe if I am in competition with
them, it's not even competition.
You're
just being challenged and inspired.
So these things, they have levels. Don't be a witch, don't be a wizard. Nobody is saying that. So
not learn. Now let's go to how to what are those consequences when somebody is wallowing in that pool of envy? What happens to the person?
Maybe you will do translation of this one, because I cannot say it in English. Oh, Nishirin. Amen.
Bam!
I can't say it.
You will not do good.
You will not
you cannot prosper. You cannot be successful. It's not cause, sorry.
It's not cause. You cannot do well. It's a truth. Like, it's just the something. It's the normal. You cannot. There's no peace for the weekend.
So have you heard, if you're out there and you probably, and it starts as a seed, you can start from that unhealthy jealousy or whatever.
It starts from thoughts. Just having that thought. Make kilora. Kiloshe. Kilokosi.
Witchcraft.
Envy was there from that aspect.
So from that moment, you deal with it, because that seed now begins to grow into a tree that will not be difficult to uproot and cut down. You understand? So now, I don't want this video to be so long as well. So let us go into how do you now deal with it? Okay, now I know that I have the spirit of envy in me. And as a child of God, it should not be so. What do I do? Like, I'm now being sincere with myself. But no, Christy. Only envy. Ilara, no. You have it. I've recognized it. I've seen it. I have examples. I've looked at this person. I've seen that. I was envious of this. Now, how do I now undo it? How do I let it go away?
You know, I'm going to answer you on based on the fact that I'm a child of God, right? I have the Holy Spirit. If you are not a child of God, maybe you can meet your dad to teach you what to do. Because I don't know. But as a child of God, you will still go and meet our dad. You go and meet the Holy Spirit. I have identified that something is wrong with me. Upstairs and downstairs and middle stairs. yes, you will help me to deal with this thing. Because the truth is, none of our weaknesses can be dealt with by ourselves. That is the truth. Is it lust? Are you battling with pride? Are you battling with lie? There is nothing, there is no weakness of us that we can actually work on our own. It takes the grace of God and the help of the Holy Spirit. So if you have identified that you actually are envious, you know, in man BS thing, really, just I'll go and meet God. But if you are not a child of God, as like I said, I don't know how you do in your family. So you may go and meet your lawyer or your dad. So go away.
So as a child of God, just pray to God to help you.
And then, yeah, pray to God to help you and consciously work on yourself. When you begin to have bad thoughts towards somebody, tell devil, Satan, not today, not ever. I'm not entertaining these thoughts. Because the truth is, even the Bible made us understand that the glory of sun is different, the glory of moon is different, the glory of star is different. And that does not mean that sun will function as moon. If we should see sun during the night, kinoku.
Erunio, everybody will.
What are you going to do? Chani, you don't hate us, Keta. Chani, berries. So, these things, just encourage yourself in the Lord that your time will come. Let the person shining shine. That doesn't mean that the person will stop shining. Okay. It doesn't mean that the person will stop shining, but the truth is nobody reigns forever. So, at the point we will stop shining, that's just the truth. So, let that person that is shining now, let the person shine. And just hold on to the truth that you are the head and not the tail, that your own time too will come. Hey, I'm talking about this thing from personal experience. You see this one? This one is a major source of concern to me. This girl, she's if you are friends with this girl, you would think, Warunu, like this girl, she does it effortlessly. She just keeps you on your toes. You know, you want to be better, you want to live life, because this girl lives like I wish that she would do video for you people. She will be truthful enough to show you her closet, to show you her shurak, to show you this, to show you her kitchen, to show you everything.
It have do, I beg. Don't come and cast in your life. Well, can you come? No. I beg, Jared. Okay, there was something I wanted to say soon. I saw something online recently. They said, somebody wrote, the person said, imagine that your lips was where your eyes are. I'm serious, chill. And imagine that your nose was where your lips
are. Ah, my foggy.
And you know, like the parts of your body are there, but in different places. Do you know that they will not perform their function?
They will not.
This your two legs. Now imagine they are on your head. How will you walk? Do you understand? Jigget. So those things are in their rightful position.
True.
So that is how it is when you are trying to run another man's race.
True.
Out of envy. You will not make sense. Ah! You cannot make sense.
What?
You cannot make sense. As in, you know, go make sense. You'll be doing it though, but it won't make sense because that is not your place. That is not your place. So the leg is best appreciated when it is where it was created to be. So if the leg decides one day that Ori ni motifem and by make sense.
So another thing, that's true. At the what she said made me just kind of give me this idea that to deal with envy too, please know yourself, carve out a niche for yourself too. Know what you are best at, what you are good at, just and focus
it.
On it. Stop looking at you don't need
that's why I feel like we still have to talk about this concert thing that happens.
That one, if we should talk about this thing, we will break tables. So,
but I don't will break that table. It's just that one is not for today.
I know.
But I'm somebody is doing concert. Let me also go and so that people
see,
will come.
We are done. Thank you
we
for
done. Thank you for thank you for joining the video. Expect more, like more. And let me say this. Anna Hef is one person that has always like given me that kind of ginger or vibe whenever I don't feel like it at all. Like, she's always there to this idea of YouTube. I think she was one of the persons that told me about that. Have a YouTube channel, always like I can have no vibes many times, and she's always like she has that energy, very good energy. So surround yourself with people with good energy, all right, so that they will help you to grow. grow and progress in your race and fulfill your purpose. So till we meet again next time on this same channel, stay blessed. And please don't forget to subscribe. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe. If you have subscribed, please turn on your notification. Because if I drop video, how will you know if you do not turn notification? So your subscription is more like a waste.
And
so
then please share our video.
Yeah, and share it. And comment.
With your friends and enemies.